番なぶなら丸市長、元市長、よろしくお願いします。
Mr. Chairman, conference members, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Sekaino kawarini ayasto tatakatero kurdo hayishi peshmarga kara konichiwa.
First of all,
I would like to pass warmest greeting from Peshmergas of Kurdistan to distinguished Hibakusha and to soul of samurai, as well to the conference members. As an ex-mayor of Rawanduz city of Kurdistan, it's a great honor to be here today to share with you the tragedies of attack on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. During the 8 General Mayors for Peace Conference, we provided a brief description of Kurdistan and our nation's struggle and suffering from chemical attacks and genocide. Since then, we have suffered several tragedies, many countries and cities have been destroyed. And we have lost so many loved ones from our civilians among Kurds, Arabs, Yazidis, Christians, and particularly among our samurai Peshmergas, the Kurdistan's international freedom fighters, because they fought against ISIS from the last 3 years on behalf of the international community. In the morning of June 9, 2014, when we woke up and realized that the new neighboring terrorist country on the border of Kurdistan within 1,050 kilometers was born. Meanwhile, Iraqi government put logistic and economical sanctions on Kurdistan. However, the Kurdish brave Peshmerga, under the leadership of His Excellency President Masoud Barzani, fought ISIS, the most horrific and vicious international terrorist organization, dangerous as atomic bombs. Eventually, Peshmerga defeated ISIS and extended its struggle to Kobani city in Kurdistan West and created great history as a symbol of international liberation. After 30 years of bombarding the city of Halabja with chemical weapons, again, ISIS used chemical weapons against Kurdish Peshmerga and the Iraqi military. The ISIS brutal action against Yazidis in Sinjar city considers as a 21st century genocide against humanity and Yazidis minority in Kurdistan of Iraq. The Kurdistan region demonstrated a magnificent example of democracy and tolerance by welcoming 1.8 million displaced Iraqi people and 300,000 Syrians who fled from ISIS and gave them refuge in Kurdistan. The war environment led hundreds of thousands of children out of schools. ISIS and some other militias, religious and sectarian groups were misusing young children and put them in the military bases and trained them how to use and to make weapons, including chemical weapons. Some of these children involved with criminal and terrorist activities, along with these kids, with other kids who have survived from ISIS, needs psychological treatment. This is an extremely critical issue and we shall take it seriously, otherwise the entire humanity of the world will be in great risk. As chairman of Education Committee at Iraqi House of Representatives, we strongly believe that the United Nations and International Community should be more dedicated to support our country. As mayor, we must all involve and committed with positive role to convince our governments to invest in education sector. In this globalized era, education is the key solution for building nations and countries, as well build a healthy society and raise our generations properly. From the past century, Iraqi regimes preserved Kurds brutally, and after 14 years of the liberation of Iraq in 2003, the new centralized government of Iraq left no other choices for Kurdish except doing referendum for independence, which is in accordance with the United Nations General Assembly Resolution 1514 of 14 December 1960. Article 4 that stated all armed action and repressive massacres of all kinds directed against dependent peoples shall cease in order to enable them to exercise peacefully and freely their right to complete independence and the integrity of their national territory shall be respected. In this regard, the Kurdistan Region Presidency decided to achieve referendum for independence on September 25, 2017. For this, we ask for your support to influence your governments and politicians to respect and recognize the result of a Kurdistan's referendum in order to enable Kurds to exercise their simple right of self-determination. We may hear some irregular voices in the region that stands against Kurdistan's referendum. However, whoever stands against the referendum, they should realize that they are against the principles of democracy that contrary to international laws, because they are seizing and violating the simple right of a nation with population of 47 million. Finally, the Kurdistan Regional Government and Iraqi government fully supporting the aims of the Mayors for Peace Conference, and in order to execute these goals, as mayors and world leaders, we should take more responsibility and put more pressure on world leaders to convince them to go toward banning nuclear and chemical weapons to save the world and civilization. The mayors, delegates of Kurdistan, standing with you in these efforts. Together we have a bright future ahead of us, and we look forward to continued cooperation between our nation to prevent tyranny and to ensure global progress on the values that unite all of us to comply with the conference's vision, which is banning the nuclear weapon by the year of 2020. I wish you all the best and thank you for this opportunity.